everyone, welcome to the 1919 Hanyu Vlogs. This is the program that provides you information about an interesting topic. So today, we will visit a country that has one of the richest and most diversified in Latin America. The nation has a variety of natural and other resources which has combined to produce an economy that is based on strong industrial base, an export-oriented agriculture sector and growing service sector. Have you found out about that country? Okay, so here are the answers for your question. Is it A, Japan, B, Argentina, C, Vietnam, or D, Korea? Have you found out? So the answer is B, Argentina. Even though Argentina is now one of the richest and most diversified country in Latin America, but now they are experiencing an economic crisis that we usually call currency crisis. So our topic today will be about Argentina and its currency crisis. So now we will have a quick overview about Argentina currency crisis. Here are brief overview about Argentina economy. Argentina has a long history of economic crisis. It has default on its external debt held by foreigners 9 times since independence in 1860. Argentina has also entered into 21 IMF program since joining the international organization in 1956. The current economic crisis facing Argentina stems from long-standing challenges as well as more recent developments. Now, you need to find out, what is currency crisis? A currency crisis is a term used to refer a type of financial crisis that encompasses an acute devaluation of a currency. That is to say, there is a sudden and often severe drop in the value of a currency. Well, this is example for you to understand more clearly about what is currency crisis. For example, let's say that you have $1. We pretend that for $1, you can get 30 Russian rubles. We will also say that this exchange rate has been pretty stable for the last 15 years ago. Then, one day, you see that the value of the rupee falls dramatically. By falling, we mean that the number of rubles you can get for $1 is now a lot more than it before. Instead of 30 rubles for $1, it may be something like 19 rubles for $1. The purchasing power of Russian rubles has gone down dramatically, and thus the currency has been partially about significant devaluation. That is currency crisis. So now, let's move to the next part to see what is now happened in Argentina. We will have a meeting with Professor Ms. Hai Ain. Professor, can you share with us some situations about Argentina?
In 2015, a new president, Mr. Mauricio Macri, started term, and he sought to change many of the abnormal aspects of the economy of Argentina left behind by President Kirchner. Despite his effort, in 2018, the economy took a turn for the worse. Argentina is grappling with a serious economic crisis. Its currency, the peso, has lost 2/3 of its value since 2018. Inflation is hovering around 30%, and since 2015, the economy has contracted by 4% and its external debt has increased by 60%. In June 2018, the Argentine government turned to the International Monetary Fund, in short, the IMF, for support. Currently has a 57 billion IMF program, the largest program in dollar terms in IMF history. Despite these resources, The government in late August and early September of 2019 postponed payments on some of its debts and imposed currency controls. In response, its central bank raised the interest rate to the world record of 60%, along with some emergency policies to emulate primary fiscal deficits, such as cutting numbers of government ministries and raising export taxes. However, this effort doesn't help much as the exchange rate between peso and the US dollar hit a new low, 39 peso per dollar. This means the value is down more than 45% against the greenback in 2018. This year, the exchange rate has increased a new low, with the exchange rate is 60 peso per dollar. Furthermore, the outcome of the presidential election on October 27 in 2019, which pitched current central right president Mauricio Macri against the central left of panelist ticket of Alberto Fernandez for president and former president Cristian Fernandez for vice president, will shape Argentina's policy response to the economic crisis in the upcoming time.
Thank you, Professor, for sharing us amazing information. Now, I'm wondering about what are the impacts on Argentina due to the economic crisis?
Thank you, Reporter Zil. Now I will invite my colleague, Mrs. Chang, to help you with these questions.
I will give some negative impacts of currency crisis on the Argentina economy. Firstly, let's talk about the inflation rate. In September 2018, the inflation rate reached the number of 30%. This is one of the highest inflation rates in the world in recent years. The high inflation rate leads to the difficulties for low-income families. They can't struggle with the problem of rising level of cost. This means that they don't have enough money to buy the things they want, such as the food or clothes, and it is also leads them to the situation of hunger and poverty. And the second effect is about import and export of goods and services. Export will suffer from double effects on all three dimensions. Orders will be less due to the foreign customer reduced imports because of their country's financial economic difficulty. The consumer demand use reduction, so the price of many export items will fail. On the other hand, imports will increase due to the reduction in world market prices and tax rates lower. So it puts the pressure on the domestic industry. Thirdly, Argentina perhaps have to face up with a decrease in foreign investment, because a foreign investment tends to flow into countries with strong and dynamic economy and a stable currency. So each country needs to have a stable currency to attract investment from foreign countries. Next, the decline in the consumption. When production is narrowed, income of some people likely to lose their jobs, and also their income being fluctuated, and it leads to the unemployment rate rise. Also, the decrease in the income combined with the drop in remittance flow will lead to decrease in household consumption. Thus, with the ability to reduce spending and investment, and also reduced in the GDP of Argentina. And also the monetary crisis can cause the financial transition will not be easy anymore, and it is even risky. the exchange rate of currency and gold price will fluctuate sharply, causing difficulties for production and businesses. And last but not least, economy recession is also an impact of currency crisis. And that's all about the impacts.
Good day, guys. My name is Ming Chang, and I'm a colleague of Zhuang Hang, Hai Anh, and Chang. So my job here today is to discuss the causes of Argentina's monetary crisis 2018. I have listed four main causes of this crisis. Let's check it out. All right, so the first cause of this major crisis is due to a drop of soy reproduction. A dry spell that set in a year ago on the Pampas grains belt continued unabated for months in Argentina, scorching soy fields and withering Argentina's top export. The country's 2017 to 2018 any crops, including the main is a soy, and other crops like corn, have also suffered from the lack of rains. So the drought. This drought has contributed to a jump of agricultural market prices and left China without one of the main feed suppliers, just as under trade tensions soared with the United States. So that's the first reason. We have come to the second cause of this major crisis. It is due to the exposure to Fed pains. Monetary policy in Washington was another source of pain for Argentina. The first Fed rate move of 2018 in March triggered a fight from all emerging market assets. Latin America's third biggest economy was particularly exposed due to its bulging macro deficits and heavy load of dollar-denominated debts. Investors turned to sell mode on the country's sovereign bonds, making it hard for the country to borrow on international markets. Fears of financial instability prompted ordinary Argentines to begin exchanging their pesos into dollars, driving down the value of Argentine currency. That will lead to the third cause of this crisis, which is the devaluation of the peso. Foreign exchange chaos has been ensured. The peso, which had been hovering at 20 per dollar since January, lost its footing in a downward spiral that sent it to 30 against the dollar in August and to 40 in September. The central bank reacted by raising interest rates and selling dollars, but it has achieved little success. President Macri turned to the IMF for help, adopt strict monetary plan to fight elasticating inflation, and pass an austere budget in Congress amid violent protests. So we have come to the final reason of this crisis. I think you can guess. It is caused by the inflation and somehow politics. President Macri, whose approval ratings has tumbled, has acknowledged some mistakes, such as setting economic goals that were too optimistic for the country and failed to coordinate policy. Economic confidence was further eroded by a corruption case that implicated major construction contractors and former President Cristina Fernandez, whose reappearance as a likely candidate in the next year's election has unnerved investors. Fernandez has denied the charges against her. So, that has enclosed to all the causes of the Argentina's major monetary crisis in 2018.
Solution to this problem that directly involves Argentina and international organizations proposed by different institutions are as follows. The first one is the government should make the IMF more sensitive to political reality. In reality, the government has launched a series of business-friendly measures that have helped the economy register solid growth in the last 7 quarters. Second is they should selectively slash government spending. The government's goal is to achieve a primary balance, that is a balance of revenue and spending at the federal level. That does not include interest rate payments. By 2020, for example, further cuts in energy subsidies, a lower wage bill, and a reduction of transfer to both provinces and state-owned enterprises. And the third one is avoid overvaluation of the currency. In a particular, the government is committed to an inflation targeting regime with freely floating exchange rate. The next one is address fiscal problems in a timely manner and devaluate Argentine peso. And the last solution I would like to give you, that is revise the fiscal and economic policies that tend to disrupt the peso. Nowadays, the currency crisis in Argentina is undergoing a tug and pull from differing sides. The public keeps a retrospective mindset as they remember the past events of 1990s and early 2000s. On the other hand, President Macri holds onto a propensive plan, trying to have Argentina climb out on the top, and even willing to take, I remember that, is a $50 billion dollar loans from IMF. There are a number of solutions that have been drawn out. Although Argentina struggles to find a national consensus, the gears are in motion to eradicate this crisis, and past mistakes are increasingly considered as a citizen politically mobilizing.
So, thank you all professors that joined us today. We hope through this video, you will have a clear understanding of the Argentina currency crisis.